Oliver here, Jewel Creek Organic Farm. I just wanted to give you guys a quick update for late August, show you where we're at in our gardens. One of our sunflowers with a bee in it and a butterfly. Our amaranth, this is the purple amaranth that we have growing here. You can see the first of the seed heads coming out there. Everything is a little bit later up here, we realize, but we figure there's some squashes. This is part of the Three Sisters beds that Micah made. There's some more corn. Anyway, we've built some hoops over the peppers that are outside and also the tomatoes that are over there that are outside. Partially because we've noticed last year we had until early October still good growing, but at nights it did go down to frost occasionally. So we decided to get this ready for September, so in September we'll be able to every night throw the plastic over some of these beds and keep some of our later and longer growing ones going. Potatoes are doing really well. Pika, you may have met in a previous video, who's here for 10 days, spent a lot of time weeding the garden, and really helped out a lot actually, because it was really quite overgrown at one point, and with Micah and Gabrielle, and there's some beans, and there's some purple beans over there. There it is. First cauliflower, sunflower with a bee working very hard. Yeah, I'll just show you here inside the greenhouse. The tomatoes that did really well for us so far this year were the smaller orange variety. And they're super sweet, they're really like tasty fruit. One of the problems that we'd had is that we didn't cut back a lot of the plants as early as we should have, and so they started to grow a little out of control, and that's why we have such a big jungly tomato house here. Here's a bunch of peppers. We've harvested a ton of them already. Really good Hungarian hot wax, quite spicy. There's some other kinds of peppers growing back here. Yeah, I'm not sure. Some sort of a jalapeno or something maybe. Here's one of our hot melon that's growing in the hothouse, in the greenhouse. But we also have some melons growing outside, which look equally big. Again, we started these quite late, and again, here's some lettuces and stuff. And check it out. There are some watermelons growing. One of the things that we found when we moved here was people were telling us, "Oh, you can't grow in this environment. It's too high, or it's too cold, or it's too extreme. It's too short a growing season, and all that kind of stuff." And you know, we didn't believe it, and we didn't want to believe it, and we simply went ahead and did it. You know, taking an example from guys like Sepp Holzer in the Austrian Alps, who is almost 1,000 feet higher than we are, and who's growing citrus fruits outside. He gets equally, you know, cold winters and short growing season, and yet is able to make grow a huge amount of stuff. So we kind of took example from that, and really didn't take any heed for people telling us that it wasn't possible to grow here. And I mean, if you look behind me here, you can see we've got a pretty rich garden. And this is just to remind you, I mean, a lot of you guys who've been watching this know that this started really late this year. We didn't start growing until really July, because in June we were still building garden beds and stuff. So we still have a lot of work to do, and we're gonna, you know, make this a lot bigger. Next year we hope to increase the size of this garden by, you know, at least another 40-50%, and make the beds a little more specialized for specific plants that we feel have done really well for us here. And we're just going to keep going. We're taking out huge amounts of tomatoes, and there's tons of zucchini and squashes coming, and that are just amazing. There's really, you know, we really haven't found anything that we haven't been able to grow here yet. And you know, we're now getting ready for for the September early, that early frost that's going to come and try and kill all the tomatoes, and has a habit of doing that. And so because of that, we've built hoop houses, little hoops over all these beds, and then plastic that's been cut and shaped to fit over, and it's going to basically every night going to get draped over. We're going to cut some of these plants down now and start to maximize them putting their energy into the fruit as opposed to growing. And yeah, we should have a lot of tomatoes coming out of this, and peppers, as you can see there. There's also, here's a big one of our eggplants. And there's another eggplant over there. And lots of different things growing here. And there's, let's see, I think we got zucchini growing here. There's different kinds of lettuces. There's a zucchini or a squash of some kind. They look a little different than these zucchinis. These ones here seem to sort of pop out of a central stem. If you can see that one there with the flower on top. Really tasty. Any case, that's the late August update for you on the farm. And yeah, now is really the harvest time. We're really, you know, spending a lot more time harvesting. We're still, you know, working on some of the plants and stuff, but we're really loving it up here, and you know, I really feel that there's nothing that we can't grow with a little bit of work. So yeah, anyway, thanks for tuning in, and cheers.